It's a heart-wrenching interview by the young widow of Narendra Kumar, an IPS officer run down by a tractor trolley driver when he was trying to stop illegal mining in Madhya Pradesh last week. A distraught Madhurani, who is an IS officer, has said she is disgusted by the government attitude. She told NDTV, why should anyone serve the country when the government treats them like this? She still doesn't have the FIR in the case or the post-mortem report. Meanwhile, the chief minister told NDTV, what mafia? There is no illegal mining mafia in Madhya Pradesh.
I am still serving in the government. I am still working as an officer of their government, and I'll be serving them throughout my life. No sensitivity, no condolence has been conveyed to me till date. Why would anybody serve the country if the fate is going to be like this?
Madhu hai, wo meri Madhya Pradesh ki beti hai, wo hamari behan ke saman hai, choti behan hai, wo hamari, unka dard, unki
baat nahi kar paye sir, unki
kathinai main samajh sakta hoon.
An officer who is serving in the cadre is not being provided with the FIR. Postmortem report has not been provided till date. At least, if postmortem, and I doubt the postmortem also.
लैंड ऑर्डर के बारे में मैं पूरी दृढ़ता के साथ कहता हूं, पूरे विश्वास के साथ कहता हूं कि हमारे देश के बाकी राज्यों में बेहतर है मध्य प्रदेश, लेकिन दुर्भाग्यपूर्ण घटनाएं होती है, इतना बड़ा प्रदेश है, कोई इसे इनकार नहीं कर सकता.
I was not scared before also, I'm not scared today also, and I won't be scared in my future also.
The voice of a young widow there, she is also expecting their first child. Well, joining me on that in our special debate, I'm still Arvind Kejriwal, also Colonel V.N. Thapar, the father of young Lieutenant Vijayan Thapar, martyred in Kargil, M. Shanmugam, the father of another young man who died fighting the oil mafia, Manjunath. Also with me, Ajay Singh of the Congress in Madhya Pradesh, and Chandan Mitra, Rajya Sabha MP from Madhya Pradesh. Thank you all. Arvind, you've been making this point for a while now. Narendra Kumar, I think, has brought this issue into focus again. Whistleblowers are not protected by the government. Heroes like this are not protected by the government. The issue is that when will politicians go beyond condolence messages? Your thoughts?
Yeah, you're very right. I think it's not just one murder. It's one in the series of murders that have taken place in the last few years. Satyendra Dubey was murdered. Manjunath was murdered. An officer who was fighting against the oil mafia in Maharashtra a few months back was murdered, and now Narendra Kumar has been murdered, and there have been many other murders which have been reported. So one thing is very clear, that the officers who dare raise their voice against mafia in the government, the message from the corrupt people is that if you dare raise your voice, we will indulge in corruption, and if you dare raise your voice, you will be eliminated. I think it has become an extremely urgent situation, and all the parties should come together and put their heads together to find a viable solution to it. We need very strong laws to protect our whistleblowers. Mm-hmm. We cannot wish away with the fact that illegal mining is taking place, and it is taking place in all the states. It is taking place in Karnataka, where BJP has been there. It has taken place in Goa, where Congress has been there. It is taking place in Madhya Pradesh. So irrespective of the parties, it is taking place in all the states. Mm-hmm. So I think it's, rather than playing politics on this issue, what is extremely important is a credible inquiry should take place, and strong whistleblower protection laws should be there.
Mr. Shanmugam, if you could just come in here. In the end, the system wins against individuals. That even though your son's death in many ways brought in the original whistleblowers bill, in the end, it's never anyone powerful who is punished. It's always the small fry or the people who may actually have carried out the murder. But the larger issues at stake are never actually in focus. Do you agree, Mr. Shanmugam?
Madam, see, this has happened in our country many places. But this law and order should be very strict. The case is, whatever happened, immediately that case should be taken and action to be taken immediately. The punishment to be given immediately. Then only the other people, they aware that, so much severe punishment they are giving. Mm-hmm. We should not do like that. They will afraid. The problem is the putting in the court, going on, hearing, so many years. Now already 6 years is over. Now the district court, high court, now it is in the Supreme Court. Supreme Court, it has gone already 1 year over, yet to be taken, the case yet to be taken. That is the problem, that immediate punishment should be given.
The NDTV news app had redefined the entire genre. Now another market beater. It's already hit number one.
NDTV Profit, India's number one finance app. Download free at ndtvprofit.com/apps. Live stream of NDTV Profit, market news, and your easy to manage portfolio. Download now, ndtvprofit.com/apps.